Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 14th November, on the front page you have Office of Chief Justice of India comes under RTI Act. So this is what the 5-judge constitutional bench of the Supreme Court has ruled. It was headed by Chief Justice of India Ranjan Gogoi himself, and it declared that Office of CJI is a public authority under RTI Act. So this is actually upholding the Delhi High Court's ruling. The one single judge bench of Delhi High Court had ruled so. Even the appeal in Delhi High Court to a larger bench had also ruled on the same. And now the case went to the Supreme Court, which has also ruled that CJI is a public authority under RTI Act. So it is actually the Secretary of the Supreme Court, which is itself the appellant in this case. So, Supreme Court, actually the judges here, they have no obligation to declare the assets also. But to ensure transparency, it has been voluntarily initiated that some judges have declared the assets. So, actually all judges should declare the assets, they are public authority. Also, the case per se was regarding the communication between the Collegium of the Supreme Court and the government regarding appointments of judges. So, the information was sought under RTI Act, but Secretary of the Supreme Court refused information saying that we don't come under RTI. But now the Supreme Court has ruled, Supreme Court, the office of the Supreme Court is also a public authority under RTI. Then this is, Supreme Court upholds disqualification of 17 Karnataka MLAs by Speaker. So, the Supreme Court has upheld the disqualification of these 17 dissident Congress and Janata Dal secular legislators by then Karnataka Assembly Speaker R. Ramesh Kumar. So, this disqualification on the grounds of defection is under 10th schedule of the Constitution. But then the Supreme Court also declared that they are disqualified, but then it said there was no bar on them from contesting re-elections. They've been allowed. We have seen Karnataka elections, assembly elections have been scheduled in December 2019, and they will be able to contest. Then below you have amended Finance Act. Supreme Court strikes down rules on tribunal postings. So Constitution Bench of the Supreme Court struck down in entirety rules framed by the government under Finance Act of 2017 to alter the appointments to 19 key judicial tribunals, including the Central Administrative Tribunal. So, you can see this is the rules which the government has framed in 2017. So, these rules actually under the Finance Act of 2017 are contrary to the parent enactment and the principles envisaged in the Constitution. So, they are struck down. Then below you have JNU partially rolls back hostel fee hike. So, we had seen how JNU had been protesting for the last few days, the students union here, for rolling back of hostel fee hike and other restrictions which have been placed on students in hostels. But this partial rollback actually has not satisfied students, and they have called the decision a gimmick and demand full rollback. And this is at 4.62% retail inflation climbs to a 16-month high. So driven by food inflation at 6.93%, retail inflation is highest since August 2016. On page 8 you have, Kerala will oppose Riverlink project. So the Kerala government is taking all precautions to prevent the implementation of Pampa Achankoil Vaipar Riverlink project. So, Tamil Nadu government, it is said, is pushing for the project, but Kerala has opposed the move at the 6th Special General Meeting of National Water Development Agency in August 2019. So, state government is opposing this while Tamil Nadu is pushing for it. You can see this Union Jal Shakti Minister has given an assurance that river interlinking projects would be undertaken only with the approval of the states involved. So in this case, if a Pampa Achankoil Vaipar river link, Pampa and Achankoil are rivers in Kerala, and it proposes diversion of 634 mm3 of water from Pampa and Achankoil rivers of Kerala to Vaipar basin in Tamil Nadu. So Kerala opposes it. On page 9 you have, they save people from cyclones, but who is saving the Sundarbans mangroves? So mangroves protect the land from cyclones, but then environmental experts point that there's constant degradation of the mangrove forests. So even this very severe cyclonic storm Bulbul made a landfall at Sagar Island in the Indian Sundarbans. A group of tourists found themselves stranded near the island in the region, but they got out of their boat and took shelter in mangrove creeks, and they escaped unhurt. So mangroves helped protect people from cyclones, but then the destruction here taking place, the rapid destruction, is a cause of concern. It is said that a satellite image in 2014 showed that there's a loss of 3.71% of mangrove and non-mangrove covers, along with massive erosion of archipelago's landmass. So this is the satellite data which shows how there's degradation taking place here. On the editorial page, the first editorial is disqualified yet qualified. So in the Karnataka MLS case, we saw in the front page news that Supreme Court has clarified that law and interplay between resignation and disqualifications, how it should be interpreted. But then this case happened so that the 17 MLAs, they have been disqualified on grounds of defection, in the sense they were members of Congress and JDS, and after being elected to the Karnataka Legislative Assembly, they defected and they joined BJP. So these former Janata Dal Secular and Congress MLAs were disqualified by the Speaker on grounds of defection, but the Supreme Court has upheld their disqualification, but they can participate in elections further. That is what the Supreme Court has clarified. And the second editorial is gloom deepens. So this is regarding shrinking industrial output, which signals slowdown. So it is some distance from bottoming out now. So the slowdown continues to be deeper and deeper. So that is a cause of concern. The lead article, narrowing options in Jammu and Kashmir. So this article says that India needs to win the battle of minds within the country before trying to justify itself in the eyes of the world. So this is in Jammu and Kashmir. So there are, the people are not convinced about the action taken in Jammu and Kashmir. The human rights violations which have taken place here, basic human rights being denied to the population. And then you have Nehruvian consensus under siege. So this is regarding Jawaharlal Nehru. It is his birth anniversary today on 14th January, which is also celebrated as Children's Day. So this article says that Jawaharlal Nehru's stature and moral authority now under attack were the guarantors for modern India's social contract. So even Nehru's ideas are attacked. Jammu and Kashmir, the situation in Jammu and Kashmir also has been presently blamed by the Modi government on Jawaharlal Nehru. Then on the op-ed page, you have far removed from reality. So this is what we have been talking about every time Central Vista news came, that government wants to revamp the parliament, have new buildings established, and entire Central Vista stretch, the Rajpath, they want to revamp it. They want a new construction to be undertaken here. It's a huge project which they plan. So this rush to redesign the Central Vista, this article says, proves how cut off the regime is from the needs of ordinary Indians. Then this is a balancing act. So this says that information flow can be facilitated without compromising privacy rights or national security. So Supreme Court has decided to transfer to itself from several high courts all cases concerning decryption of WhatsApp messages and tracing the original senders. So hearings in this case are taking place. So this article talks about that. Linking Aadhaar to social media profiles, this is being challenged. On page 12, you have Congress welcomes court decision on money bills. So the Congress has welcomed the Supreme Court's decision to refer the case on Centre's decision to club nearly 20 bills under the Finance Act as a money bill to a larger constitutional bench. So this is claimed by Congress to be a victory. So these steps by government, who call bills at money bills, is being questioned now. So if Supreme Court gives a thumb down, the government will have to bring separate legislations for all the 19 laws passed as money bills. So these bills are those which are diluting National Green Tribunal. The Aadhaar Act also and also other bills which have been passed. So these money bills, they give power, voting power only to the Lok Sabha. Rajya Sabha can debate on it, but it is not mandatory that Rajya Sabha should pass the bill. So, you know, so Congress does not have majority and the ruling party has majority in Lok Sabha. So if it's a money bill, it can easily be passed by the ruling party. So many bills are clubbed as money bills and passed. But now this case is before the Supreme Court. So this case is presently, the case has not ruled. In this case, ruling is not against this action, but this case has been referred to a larger constitutional bench. Then this is again the front page news about regarding CJ office coming under RTI Act. On page 13, you have economy to be main topic at BRICS summit. So BRICS summit is going to take place at Brazil, in Brasilia. And it is said that economy will be the main topic. Prime Minister Narendra Modi also will be here along with other leaders. Then this is regarding Bolivia. You can see the entire timeline given regarding coups in Bolivia, successful as well as unsuccessful shown. You can see blue shows unsuccessful and yellow show successful coups over the years from 1950 to 1985. And then first indigenous president to have full term was Evo Morales, against whom protests are taking place. He stepped down and now he is in Mexico. Then on business page, you have rupee slips 62 paise to 2 month low. So in the absence of RBI's intervention, the currency could drop to 72.5 levels as such, is what the dealers also say, against dollar. So 72.5 against dollar. Then it is that gold is third most popular investment. So it comes behind savings, life insurance, and is seen as protection against inflation. So this is what the World Gold Council said. Then on the last page, you have climate change is harming health of children, says Lancet report. So it says infants will bear the greatest burden of malnutrition and rising food prices. So climate change is already damaging the health of world's children, and it is set to endanger their well-being of the entire generation unless the world meets the targets to limit warming to well below 2 degrees Celsius as in the Paris Climate Accord. So this is a study. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.